Okay, so today I'm going to show you some simple measuring techniques, the way that an artist measures using a pencil and their hand. And what they do is they'd stretch their arm out fully extended without bending the elbows, and then they'd choose something from which they were going to measure the whole of the object. And it's usually something small. So I think I'll pick this small tire at the front, and I'm going to put the tip of my pencil onto the edge of the tire and then slide my thumb down till it gets to the other side of the tire, like that. And then I can use that distance without moving my elbow to measure the distance between the two tires. And it's one tire, one and a half tires. So there's one and a half tyre widths from the edge of that to the edge of the next tyre, and that will help me draw it in. Because however big I draw this tyre, I can draw it any size on my paper, I know that the distance between the two tyres is one and a half times however big I draw that. Okay, that might be a little bit confusing, so let's just have a look. The back, there's my one tyre again, and there's my one and a half, and then that tyre is one, probably about one and a quarter tyres, it's bigger. And if I look at other measurements, and I take the distance between the two tyres, put my pencil point on the edge of that one, my thumb, and then I measure the top of the car, look, I can see the distance between the tyres is the same as the top of the car. And then if I hold that end and I move my thumb onto it, I can now see that actually the car is about two of those distances. There's the distance between the tyres, one, two. I can even measure the height of the car, which is again about the same distance from there to there, is about the height of the car. Okay, so when I come to draw the car, I can do the wheel any size I want to fit on my page. And now I know that the next wheel is one, and a half times, and then I'll start to draw my next wheel. Now all both the wheels are going to be resting on the ground, so they'll have to be in line, and then I know it's got to go there, and I know it's going to be about one and a quarter times the width, one and a quarter times, so about that big. And then can do that. That's the width of the tyre, that's the ground it's resting on. And then I can just join them up to make a proper circle. And that's my back tyre drawn. And I also know now that this distance is the top of the car. So if we just quickly mark out where that begins, it kind of begins about there, and then it's going to be about there. I'm just checking that point where it would slope down like that. But I have to now check the height, and remember that was just less than a car width. So I'm going to draw the bottom of the chassis of the car like that. And then it's that distance is going to be about the top of the car there. So now I know that distance, I can now measure it in just a few simple points, and I can mark in the front window, which is a bit smaller than that. And then I know the front of the car is about that size again, so it's going to end about there. and that will help me get the dimensions and the sizes of the car correct.